I just graduated with chemical engineering from the University of Illinois, and I'm the CEO and co-founder of Miss Possible. My co-founder and I were both female engineering students. When we recognized that there weren't that many other women in our classes, we started to get involved in volunteering in the community, doing science and engineering with kids, and that really became a passion for us. And we saw this problem that we cared a lot about, getting more women into engineering and really getting more girls to dream about the impact they can have on the world. And once we started looking at that from the lens of the business world and from entrepreneurship, we came up with the idea that eventually became Miss Possible.
Test tubes and stuff, and then when they swipe to the right, it's like Bessie playing with like a little plane or something.
That would be so cool.
It would be like Ada.
We thought dolls were a really great way to get to girls when they're young and get to them in a way that's still really comfortable and accessible to them. But I'm a college kid, how the heck do I manufacture dolls? No single one of us has the skills needed and has the time and energy needed to launch a business on our own. So there's a lot of collaborative work. So bringing Kelly on was a really big deal, and getting someone who's just as invested and just as excited about this and have these critical skills that we needed was a huge step forward for us.
I never designed a doll before, obviously. And I think design is a lot about collaboration. So we definitely had that communication going on, saying, what if she had this type of hair? Oh, what kind of personality does she have? Is she spunky? And then we started sketching. We came up with, I don't know how many, but we came up with several sketches. And it started just coming towards this kind of final design at the end.
Do you want me to switch her around, like flip her? Or,
Every Miss Possible doll comes with access to an app. And as much as the doll offers opportunities for imaginative play, the app offers opportunities for girls to really learn and get experience with these fields that they might not otherwise get to interact with. So for example, our first doll is Marie Curie. And on the app, girls can read the story of this woman and learn about the obstacles that she overcame to get to this place in her career. But then they also get to see Marie Curie on the screen walking them through chemistry and physics activities that they can do with materials around the house. Doll is something that you play with. It's really imaginative. You can be friends with this character, and that's really what we're trying to do with these strong role models that might otherwise not be really relatable to girls. Someone like Marie Curie, having achieved 2 Nobel Prizes, is, I can't always see myself in her position, and I think that's even harder for a 10-year-old. So introducing these women through dolls was a way for them to be really relatable, really accessible, and a lot of fun.
Everything we use every day has been touched by a designer one way or another. So I'm really excited about implementing my creative side and art into helping people. I realized through the years in industrial design, it used to be primarily a male profession, but slowly and surely there are more girls starting to join the program. And I hope in the future we do design a doll based on industrial design.
It's actually pretty good.
Yeah, it's not bad.
And you can always change the color.
We're starting with dolls and apps and trying to reach as many girls as we can right now, but this is just the start for Miss Possible. We can't wait to make more dolls and feature more women and get a lot of these women who maybe aren't appearing in textbooks, get them the 15 minutes or many more minutes of fame that they really deserve.
Supriya is really a great role model. I think I look up to her. She is great at what she does. And it's clear, you can see the passion in her eyes.
Juggling school and work is a lot. But I think part of what makes it possible is I'm not doing things just because I feel like I have to. I'm doing things that I honestly feel passionate about. Everyone says timing is really important to startups and, you know, it's really critical to success. And I have to say, I think now is the best time we could possibly do this.